My name's Brandon Harpool. I'm calling to see if y'all could do anything about a student at our school. She has epilepsy, and she needs to go down to Miami, Florida for day testing, but they don't have the money to get down there. So we were wondering if there's any way that y'all could maybe help out.
Let me see what I can do, okay, Francis? And okay. Can I call you right back?
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Bye.
Get ready. She's coming soon. So just be quiet and listen. When she walks in the door, y'all scream and be loud until I stand up and then I'm like this. Okay?
In January, we had an appointment with Dr. Winchester, who's our neurologist, and we were going over all the medications that Taylor had been on. Taylor suffers from epilepsy.
Complex partial seizures are a type of seizures which start in one particular part of the brain, and they can spread to other parts of the brain.
Some of her seizures may last 30 seconds, some may last up to 3 minutes. But after her seizures, she is so worn out, she can sleep for hours. Sometimes like 4 o'clock in the afternoon to 6 o'clock in the morning.
It can cause a lot of school difficulties. They can get behind in their schoolwork. They can lose track of what the teacher is saying and require some accommodation, some increased time on tests.
Dr. Winchester and I have talked and talked and talked. She told us that she was going to refer us down to Miami Children's Hospital for an evaluation and a surgical consult. Dr. Winchester asked her, she said, Taylor, what is your number one goal? Taylor said, my goal is to drive. What teenager doesn't want to drive? You know? So she says, well, this could possibly make that goal.
Student Government Association has about 40 members and do a great job of representing the students in the school.
I have been hugely surprised at the results that these kids get, because everything they do, they're calling on their own. They're talking to these business people, to these corporate people by themselves. I do basically nothing except enable them, you know, try and help them figure out the problems.
Taylor Collins came to us a few weeks ago telling us her situation about how she needed to get down to Miami, Florida for her epileptic test that she needs to get done. And she looked down and she's like, I can't do this. I don't have the means of doing this. I don't know how we're going to pull this off.
We don't have a lot. We're on a very, very tight income. Very. Her dad and I are trying to figure out how this is going to work. We just kept telling her, don't worry about it. We're going to make this happen. We're not sure how yet, but we're going to get there. We're not going to lose this opportunity, no matter what. We're not going to lose this opportunity.
We researched a bunch of different places about who could possibly take her, and then we came across Angel MedFlight. We did a bunch of research into it and really figured out if that would be the best thing. And turns out it was the best thing.
They sent information home with Taylor. The following day, I called. I explained who I was. I said, you know, hi, I'm Quintina Collins. I'm Taylor's mom. And she's like, well, I want to tell you that we would like to donate your flight. And I was like, almost dropped the phone. I was just in shock. I was like winning the lottery for my child. I was just so overwhelmed. And then she told me, but it has to be a secret. You can't tell. And I'm like, ah!
We'll be right back. want to thank them all. I was so surprised that I didn't know how to act. I was just overly surprised. So I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to all of them.
In all of my experience as an administrator, kids are resilient, and they do rally around people who are in need, and sometimes they teach us lessons that we forget as adults.